from your rookie year. Last 2 years, you've shot lights out from three.
Right.
I mean, how have you been able to continue to hone that skill to the point that you might end up the, you know, a starting stretch four on this team?
Man, I think it's just putting in a lot of extra work as far as critiquing the balance and the little things that go into shooting a jumper. And just really spend a lot of time on it and really trying to perfect it.
Yeah, Ryan said it. I mean, we've seen your game grow so much throughout the course of the past few seasons. And even with the Hawks, such a fun team. You guys had
such
a fun team to watch last year. But as you look how you fit in with this group, what stood out to you playing with the guys? I know you haven't started training camp yet, but the last few weeks being out at workouts and just seeing the ways in which you'll fit with this team.
I think how versatile a lot of us are and how interchangeable we are in the positions we play. One through four can pretty much play it all, bring the ball up the court, and I think that's going to serve a purpose for us in being that much more difficult to guard.
You know, we've seen Kenny Atkinson firsthand just do an unbelievable job with developing talent.
Yeah.
As a player who has plenty of talent and is still a young, developing player, how excited were you to get the chance to work with him and the player development staff here to continue to hone those skills?
Right. That's what a big thing was for me, knowing that Kenny is a great development coach. And along with being the head coach, it just brings it so much more understanding as far as a player and a coach relationship, knowing that he wants the best for you and knows that he wants to have you improve as a player, and it just helps your confidence as a player overall.
For you, how do you approach training camp, you know, now that you've got a couple under your belt and you're continuing to get older and knowing that things are going to get started? Yeah, I know, for real, tomorrow. Speaking of Kenny, how do you approach it now, having a better understanding, but also being in an organization and with a team that's new and different?
I think you just approach it as a professional, as professional as you can, and do what you do and be the player that has got you this far, which is trying to be the best defender I can be, hitting shots, making shots for other players, and now being able to play with some very elite players. I think making shots is very important, being efficient and just doing the simple things.
What have your impressions so far been of Kyrie on the court and how you'll fit in with him on this team?
I think his leadership. It's not a surprise to me because I've seen him play and I've seen him communicate with past teammates, but his leadership is big. He talks. He runs, obviously, the point guard positions. He's a commander, and he demands a lot out of you, and I think that just elevates everybody around him.
Anyone else that's really stood out to you? I know a lot of you are friends, and some have more experience playing against each other, with each other, but is there anyone else that's really stood out to you so far these past few weeks?
I would have to say Caris LeVert and Spencer Dinwiddie. You see those guys play, you play against them, but the intellect that Spencer plays with is very high, and I've tweeted this before. Caris has one of the quickest first steps I've ever personally had to guard, and so that just speaks volumes, and I'm glad they're my teammates now.
You guys are all, and Kevin talked about this a little bit, but you're all fans of the NBA. You'll watch the NBA. The landscape changed a lot this offseason, not just with the talent here, but all across. Because of the way it changed, do you look at it and say, hey, this thing is wide open for the taking? I mean, I know it's different if Kevin comes back or doesn't come back, whatever, we all get that. But, I mean, how much does that energize you and teams across the league to think this golden ball's up for grabs?
Yeah, as a competitor, you should always think that. But, I mean, like you said, now that the teams have changed, people have went where they went, it's even more open and there's more opportunity there. So, I get that brings players to work harder, look at the goal and believe in a way.